that ain't my thing.
You was flowing.
How y'all doing tonight? It's time to cook, man.
That's a nice groove.
Yeah. It's Friday night, y'all. That's what it's about. Cooking, conversation, cocktails. We have some good conversation, too, all week long. Wednesday, Friday, and Saturday. So I thank you guys. Thank you for hanging out with us. Mm-hmm. Hey, baby, how you doing?
I'm doing great. It's good. Friday.
It's Friday. How y'all doing? Good to see everybody.
Sharon Brown is in the house. Hey, Ms. sis.
Brown, I see you was... When I sent out the message, you started pouring it up.
Yeah. Gary Craig says, hey, y'all.
How y'all doing?
April Perry McCullum, Sharon Lewis, greetings from Georgetown, Delaware.
All right. How you doing? Time to cook. Time to hang out. Hope you settled in for the night. It's been a little cool here where we live. You know, I don't know what it's like where you live. But it's a good time for fire and
soups.
And we had some soup this week.
Yes.
Yeah, some vegetable soup. And with a little prime rib in it too. And all kind of stuff I could find to throw up in that sink. Yeah, we had some fun with that. So so let's get some started, man. We're going to do, we got like 2 more weeks I'm going to do. Two more weeks that I'm going to do like some little small bites. And then we're going to get off into some other stuff. Because the new year is going to start. And boy, with these small bites, nothing's been healthy. We've had a little lettuce and a little stuff thrown in there. I'll throw some lettuce in tonight. But the first of the year, we're going to have to do some...
cleansing.
Some cleansing, huh?
Yes, yeah. Cleansing of the arteries. Yeah.
So we're going to do some sliders tonight. We're going to do... some meat sliders, some turf sliders, and we're going to do some surf sliders. We're going to do some shrimp sliders. And the turf sliders are venison.
What is that?
What is venison?
Yes.
Venison is venison. Venison is deer.
Deer. Bambi.
Oh, don't say Bambi. Don't say Bambi. We don't hurt Bambi.
No, we don't hurt
Bambi. We get the other ones out there.
No Bambis were hurt
so
in the making of the video.
We're doing some venison sliders, and actually I made the buns today, some brioche buns. I don't know if you've been checking me out, but made some brioche buns. Put a little white sesame seeds and some black sesame seeds on them. So fresh bread.
Fresh bread.
Gonna mold up the meat, and then I'm gonna make a little shrimp salad to go for the other one. That's cool?
That's cool, baby.
Yeah, a cool little bite that we're going to have for Friday night. So if you think about all the little dishes we've done this month, man, you put all those things together the last 2 weeks, you got yourself a nice little gathering, you know, next year for New Year's Eve. How about that?
There you go. I'm going to say hey to a few people.
Please do that. And while I grab shrimp.
Okay. Karen Tony, hello. How's the beautiful family doing? We are well, Karen. Thank you for your for tuning in. Thank you for joining. Angela Stitt Williams is watching.
That's
hello,
my,
Chef
that's
Q.
My first cousin.
That's your first that's yeah. our first cousin.
Yeah,
that's my greatest daughter. Hello again. Diane Lacey, hello, Chef Kip. Sharonda Gatewood, happy holidays to you guys from Detroit, Michigan. Thank you for joining. This is Markeela Goodwin, blessed. Geraldine James, hello, Mr. and Mrs. Kevin Jack says he's under 8 inches of snow.
Oh, my goodness.
Yes, from Pennsylvania.
Mercy.
Hi, Mr. and Mrs. Kip. Happy holidays. That's Martha Harvey Lewis. Vanessa Thompson says, hi, beautiful couple.
Happy holidays to you. Yeah.
Y'all got that little snippet. Monica Tover Jackson says, hey, guys, happy Friday.
I'm over here washing some lettuce, guys. That's why I disappeared.
I'm going to come into these homemade brioche buns. Can y'all get into that? With black and white sesame seeds. The seeds are not burnt. Let's just put that in the atmosphere.
Yeah, that's funny.
Black and white sesame
that's
seeds.
Funny, yeah.
He's going to use these to make his sliders tonight. Hello, sister Gwendolyn Bacon Jones. Hello, my beautiful family. Shirley Motley is on. Hello, y'all. Brandon Williams says, how you doing today? How was your day?
Hey, Brandon, how you doing, buddy?
It was busy, but we got through it. Thankful to be busy. Nettison and Rogers, hey, you guys. Shirley Faye Williams Davis, hey, y'all. Happy holidays. Love you both. Thank you so much for the love. Erlinda Freeman, yummy, yummy, yummy. Yes, ma'am.
Yummy, yummy, yummy in my tummy. All right.
There are the shrimp. I'm going to back out.
Don't get me have my spot back?
Yes.
I'm coming back. Okay.
All right.
It's warm in here.
It may be, babe.
It may be. Okay. I don't know what it is. Hey, you know what I need to do?
What?
To work. We used to do the food and then, I like the song, I turn it up a little bit.
Okay.
But to work, you know, we get out. Like I said, cooking. I should have said cocktails, cooking, and conversation. Huh?
Yeah, because that's the order.
So I was, I enjoy ginger beer. Ginger beer is a kicked up ginger ale. I'm sure you guys know what ginger beer is. It's not a beer. But I paired it with some spiced rum today. And boy, I was just trying out something before we got started today.
You want to show the ginger beer?
Yeah, and I like it. So many. This is a Bermuda one. Actually, I think the first time I had ginger beer, this is the one I had years ago. Someone that I used to fellowship with at church, one of the choir members, is from Bermuda, and she shared this with us at an event one night.
So
there's several. You can find this like in the pop section, the soda section of the grocery store. And I'm pairing it with a little Captain Morgan's Black Spice Rum.
All right.
And it kind of, when I tasted it, I put the two together. Like, it brought out notes of vanilla and creaminess. And it reminded me of, like, eggnog.
Mmm. From the spice.
Yeah, without the milk.
All right. Pour one up.
I can tell you.
Let me
that's
see.
That's what it reminded me of. So if you like eggnog, try that. So we're going to put a little crushed ice in here.
Hello, Martha Harvey Lewis. She said, I like Jamaican ginger beer.
Yeah.
Carolyn Lee Smith, those dinner rolls look so good. Yes. He's been into baking his own buns.
Yeah, brioche.
Brioche buns for a minute there. Wadora Pettaway is watching.
Hey, Wadora, I'm free pouring tonight because I can. In the restaurant business, I've seen somebody do this. I'd be ready to tell somebody, you can't work here anymore.
Ernest Carter is watching.
That was spiced dark rum.
Dark rum, and we're mixing it with ginger beer. That's the cocktail. Conversations, cocktail, and cooking on Friday night.
I always like mint because it just kind of, I'm going to break it a little bit and kind of do that.
And that's releasing the flavor.
Yeah, and it's going to, I'm going to take that one out. It always adds a little freshness to it and that aroma that it gives to it.
Okay. I'm going to try
it. So that's yours, sweetheart.
Thank you, babe.
I got one. It's watered down, so I'm about to tighten mine up a little. All right, so let's get this thing going on.
Oh, it's delicious.
We got a cocktail. Now we're going to mix up. Let me wash my hands real quick.
Quentin Levant said that's an excellent ginger beer.
What's up, Q? I missed you the other night, man. I know you was on, but I didn't see it at the time. Hope you don't get buried in that Detroit weather.
Yes, it's snowing in a lot of places across the U.S. Erlinda Freeman said Captain Morgan, it's her favorite. She's going to have to try that.
Okay, please do. So I'm going to make this real simple. When I make a burger, it's a slider, I don't do a lot to it. And I learned this from, I never had formal training, by the way. As far as being a chef, never had formal training. I've worked in restaurants and did all kind of stuff, but boy, have I done a lot of studying over the years, from books to videos to reading to meeting people to working with people, and mostly I've been in restaurants more so than cooking in a restaurant.
Mm-hmm.
But what I found is the best way to taste the essence of the meat is just plain old salt and pepper. I'm gonna add a little bit of garlic tonight, just a little bit, because if you put too much garlic powder or granulated, it's going to burn.
It burns.
Salt and pepper, it's going to get a good sear on it, bring out the flavor of this great meat. Okay?
The venison. If you're just joining.
So I don't want to overwork it. I've already washed my hands, just did it a few minutes ago. So what I mean by overworking it, I don't want to mash it too much. So I should have thought I put my seasonings in first. That is salt, ain't it?
Yes, baby, that's salt.
Okay. You know, it's not
It's not kosher. No.
It felt so fine. I'm going to grab a little kosher salt.
Yes. And why do you prefer kosher over regular table salt?
I like the way the way it releases the salt itself. I feel like I don't have to use as much.
With the kosher salt. Yeah. If you're just joining, we are cooking venison holiday sliders. Ernest Carter says, hi, family. Is this drinking with Kip or cooking with Kip? A little bit of both. Alfreda Tally says, hey, y'all. Happy holiday. Vatonia Nesbitt Thomas says she's going to try that. I'm assuming that drink.
Okay, so I'm going to put a little kosher in there.
And you can definitely see the difference in the grain from the kosher salt and the regular.
And I'm going to wash mine again because I got to use that peppermint.
Evelyn, is it Filva? Hello, everyone watching from Guam, USA. Stay safe and be blessed.
All right.
Wow.
All right, welcome.
Thank you for joining.
All right, so let's try this. Put a little fresh cracked pepper in there. I like fresh pepper. I've talked about that a few times. So I'm just really giving the flavor, a little flavor through the meat, and then I'm going to put a little bit of salt and pepper on the exterior.
Now, how would the venison cook up versus a regular ground beef burger?
Well, I'm going to be honest with you. With if you have ever had wild game, you call that cabin?
Yes.
In most cases, there's fat that's been added to it. Pork fat, beef fat, because most wild games, not all of them, but venison happened to be more lean than fat. So it's actually a healthy meat for you. But to bring the flavor out of the meat, it needs fat. So a little fat has been either, I think pork fat was actually ground into this meat. Actually, I will need that little plate over there, baby.
Okay.
You can't even do that.
This one?
Yeah, so I put these on there.
Okay.
I don't want to make these too big. Just pinch them off.
These are sliders, so we're monitoring the size.
Kind of get a good shape on them. Like I like to kind of use my, I don't know. I think my mom taught me kind of a technique like this. I don't know if this, but rolling biscuits. So, but I use my fingers to kind of create the round, and I use the other hand to kind of flatten it out, so I can get a decent round burger.
Lolita is watching.
Hey, how you doing, my friend?
And
my
high school friend, mate. Peyton says, happy holidays. James Horn is watching. This is Yvette Hicks Anderson. Hi from McDonough.
Turn that skill up a little bit more.
Georgia, what's on your holiday menu? Thinking about brisket, where's the best place market to get a good quality meat?
Wow.
From McDonough,
she's
Georgia.
In McDonough.
Mm-hmm.
Wow, you know what? What's her name again?
That was Yvonne Hicks Anderson.
Yvonne Hicks. You know what, Yvonne? You would have asked me that question 15 years ago, about 15 now. Mm-hmm. I probably could have gave a better answer. Not living in the Atlanta area anymore, I don't want to give an uneducated answer.
What about Curb Market?
Yeah, but I mean, for good beef, she wants to make what she was making the
beef brisket.
The brisket.
Mm-hmm. You want to research that?
We're going to pin your name, and I'm going to send some information out to you. And if anybody that lives in the Atlanta market, I know Ernest does. If there's a good place that you purchase some good beef, Ernest, pop it out there for us.
Mm-hmm.
But I will research it. And I know we have a few places here locally that I go. We have some local markets that we go to. And once you get to know your meat man, you're in the house because they take care of you. All right, so we're going to make about... We're going to make six, baby.
Six sliders. Okay.
Let me speed up making these things.
Dave, I finally joining you live. Love watching and learning. Happy holidays from Arizona. Thank you for joining.
Thank you.
Carol Settles, Brockington. Hi from South Carolina. Vanetta Harris says, hi, you guys. Just joining in. Let's cook. Love watching you guys from Lufkin, Texas. Thank you.
Yeah, she's been on a few times.
Hello, Thea Copeland. Jeffrey Mack is watching.
Hey, Jeff.
Hello, Tracy Jones. Thank you all for joining. Christina O'Connor Cooper. Hi from North Carolina. I really enjoy learning a lot from you guys. Thank you.
Got to make two more sliders. Two more of the. And you can't tell. If I didn't tell you this was venison, you probably wouldn't even know.
No, it looks like ground beef. Well, yeah. My good friend, Joanne Renfro Johnson. Guess what, Ty? I don't eat venison either. She said, I'll do a little ground chuck. I'm with you, sis. Shirley Simmons, hello, guys, from South Africa. Hello. Thank you for joining. Yes. That's on our bucket list.
Yes, it is. Actually, within the next 4 years.
Yes. PD Otis, glad my daughter told me about your yummy videos. I'm learning a lot of good ideas. Thank you, sir. Thank you for joining. Cornelius Delamar, former market off Ponce de Leon for the Atlanta area.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Off of Ponce? That's,
yes.
Is that the Cavs Farmers Market?
I'll see what he says.
Yeah.
Okay.
I wanted this. That was on my list of places, but you know, yeah, after a few years, you want to call out a place and it's not the same.
Happy holidays.
The Cavs Farmers Market actually is the owner, baby, and the brother, Harry's.
Harris.
Those are two brothers.
Okay.
Yeah,
and it's Harris is in Cobb and Marietta.
And used to be Marietta and Alpharetta.
Okay.
Or Roswell.
It's been a while since we've been in the Atlanta area.
Okay. That's my sixth slide. I'm going to put some back in the fridge. Wash up right quick.
Carol says she loves venison. Dr. Kimberly Johnson is in the house, Kansas City, Missouri, checking in. Happy holidays. Delicia Daniels, ground turkey sliders. These are venison. Ground turkey is
ground
always
turkey
good.
Good.
Yes. Hi from Arkansas. That's Lisa Jones.
Put this meat up.
Cornelius says yes. That's the cab.
Okay.
Yes.
Great place. Great place. All right. So I'm going to put a little bit of pepper on the outside. And where did that kosher sauce go? Where is it? A little kosher on the outside. You're going to get the cast iron hot. And because that's for my buns.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. We're moving right along, making holiday sliders. Debbie Waltman Welch says, I love seeing a man in the kitchen. Love to watch you cook. I'm from New Orleans, lives in Mississippi. All right, Debbie. I love it.
All right.
Thank you for tuning in.
More ice since Ernestine called me out.
Yes. Drinking with Kip or cooking with Kip? We can do both safely.
I thought Ernest was my boy.
No wine tonight, sis. That's Sharon Brown. We sipping on some dark spice rum and ginger beer.
Yeah, it has a good holiday twinge to it.
Okay, yes.
Got the burgers going. So I'm going to get that piping hot.
Piping hot.
Piping hot. Like smoking hot.
Smoking hot.
I want the skillet to be hot so I get a good sear on the outside. Then flip it over and then I'll probably finish it in the oven.
Okay.
And then while that's getting hot, I'm going to put these over here.
Yes, Lolita. We have an Captain Morgan's Black Spice Rum mixed with a little bit of ginger beer, if you can see that.
So now I'm going to, I took some shrimp. To make the sliders, a little bit of 21-25, actually a pound. So about 25 shrimp, huh?
25 shrimp.
About 25 shrimp. So chopping them up, and I did a rough chop. Kind of like three pieces per shrimp. And I'm going to add a little bit of mayo in there. Probably about, I don't know. I'm going to have to feel this out. I don't want it to be too creamy. I just want it to be just right. So that was probably about 3 tablespoons?
Yes. Give or take. Thank you for the stars, Batonia. She sent 150 stars. Lolita says she loves ginger beer.
All right. I don't think we did anything. Yeah, she didn't like.
I don't know about the coon, though.
I don't know if she called that.
I don't think she did either.
All right, so I'm chopping up a little red onion, a little celery, and into my salad mixture for my shrimp salad sliders.
Sharon Brown, Lola hasn't come downstairs yet.
Tomorrow
she's gonna be on camera.
Yeah. This is her final day of, well, actually yesterday really was her final day for the semester.
For the second semester. Yeah. She's a freshman in high school. She's been hybrid learning all year so far. So it's been hard for our kids.
So we're gonna put about a couple of tablespoons of onion for this little bit.
Yvonne Hicks says ginger beer is my favorite in a Moscow Mule.
Oh, yeah.
All right, now.
Oh, yeah. You can't go wrong with that. Okay, a little chopped up onion.
Lalisa says she usually buys Fever Tree.
Fever Tree, that's the name of the, is that the one in the green bottle? Because I'm not sure of the name of it.
It's the ginger beer, but she said not, she hasn't tried this one.
There's one in the green bottle. Actually, Mom has it right now. So we got that. We're going to get a little bit of something else I need.
Celery?
Yes. Thank you. I'm looking right at it. I'm like, something else I need.
So he's making, this is, he's chopping this up to go into his shrimp salad.
Well, yeah, for the shrimp salad sliders.
We're going to have shrimp salad.
Got a little surf and turf thing going on here.
Babe, they love your knives. Debbie Waltman says she need one of those knives.
Hey, it gets it done. A sharp knife is a friendly knife. This one, I sent it in to be sharpened, and it came back. They sent a new one for me. So
they replaced it. Yeah, that was a Christmas blessing.
So I'm having fun with this. Okay, so I got a little celery, about a tablespoon of celery. So I want it to be, I want a rough chop because I want it to have some texture. I want a little chunk to it. So if you're not one to like to taste and feel the onion in your mouth, well, you probably need to chop it a little finer.
Or put it in the processor.
Yeah, if you like it like that, that's cool. But I'd like a little bit of a rough chop. So I'm putting two types of onions, a little bit of the green pieces on that too.
That's fine.
It's all right. Get this up and then we're going to put the sliders into the hot cast iron skillet. Okay.
Charlene says Jamaican beer is the best. I would have to agree.
Yeah. All right. So let's get some sliders working, baby.
All right. Marilyn Brown says, what's a good brand of knives to purchase?
Wow. There's so many.
Yeah.
This Wusthof. These, I have several different ones. These that I'm using tonight, actually, knives that I
had for years.
For years. I mean, for like, year, like, there's another set I had, but like, I've been using the same type of knives for probably over 30 years. But these are actually Cutco knives. I enjoy the knife. I mean, I don't think you find that knife in the restaurants that often. Because I've used, so probably, Wusthof is probably the knife that you see in restaurants. And that's Wusthof. But this is actually my favorite knife. I used to make money selling these years ago. So I still enjoy them because I like the weight of the knife. You got a good balance, good full, what you call a good tang. I'm pulling on this knife very hard right now. And flexibility, good sharpness. And but there's so many out there, so many.
Yes.
So I got some smoke, and that's what I wanted. I wanted my skillet to be smoking some so I get a good sear.
Sherry Hiller said they got to be Cutco. They are.
Yeah, that's what they are.
That's what we wanted to hear.
Yeah.
Thank you for the stars, Carol Settles Brockington.
So you hear the sizzle? That means we got a
good and hot.
And if you get it good and hot, if it has a little stick, it won't be long. You can see I'm moving this around. And that's what the hot skillet gives you. And I'm trying not to overcrowd it too much, but that's just right. So I got them in. Wash up one more time. Put my little plate in the sink. Wash that off.
Ernest says Sam's is a good place to purchase that beef brisket.
Okay.
Yes.
Actually, I purchased one here.
Yes, Lola is an only child. Hello, my new favorite family. That's Gwen Slaughter Pounds. Hey, sis. Thank you for joining. Mario Hagans is watching.
Okay. Fantastic. Welcome, everybody. All right, so we got the sliders sizzling, and I'm gonna put just a little bit on the outside to create that good sear. Not a lot.
We are cooking holiday sliders. This actually looks just like ground beef. You can really trick somebody, but this is actually venison meat.
Don't trick them.
A lot of trickery going on around here.
All right, so I got some celery, some onions, baby, that I'm going to put into my...
Your shrimp salad.
Yeah, that's going in. Boom.
Hello from Detroit. That's Cheryl Davis. Hello, Rosa Blair. Thank you for joining.
And we're going to kick off a little bit of lime in there.
Lita Walker, first time watching from Smyrna, Tennessee. Wow. Hey,
Smyrna, Tennessee. Smyrna is on the way to Nashville.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So put a little citrus in there. And we're going to stir that up a little bit. Stir that, and then I'm going to put a little seasoning. Some of my own little private stock of seasonings right here. A mixture of some salt, some pepper, garlic.
Joanne Mears Green says she bought Cutco knives from a door salesman years ago. Do you sharpen them yourself, and how?
I do sharpen myself, and I actually just sent them in to be sharpened more in detail. But I use a whetstone to sharpen my knives. I think I bought this from actually
Amazon.
No, I didn't get that from Amazon. I think I got that at a sports store, like Dick's or somewhere like that.
Okay. Yeah.
In the honey section.
All right.
I'm going to actually add a little bit of Old Bay seasoning, just a touch. Because I like Old Bay seasoning.
Yes.
From the South. That's what we do.
It's deer meat. Rudolph, I hope not. That's Justin Heron.
You hope it's not Rudolph?
No, Rudolph ain't here yet.
All right, so let's see if we can.
Ernest said no onion on his.
No onion? All right, so we're going to flip these sliders. Oh, yeah. See that sear, that brown? That's what you want. And you can notice that it's flipping real easy because of the hot skillet that I'm utilizing. All right. I think these are going to be good, sweetheart.
I think they are. I'm excited.
Got a flip there and a flip that.
What was the the famous venison restaurant? Oh, no, that's Buffalo. Never mind. I was thinking the wrong deer. Yes, it's deer meat. Hello, Karen Powell. Bolton Thelma, hello from Mississippi. Thank you for joining. Laura Wilson, hello, you guys. Yes, it's deer meat. Oh, Andrea is crying faces.
Uh-oh.
Hello, Tony Grant. Hi, guys. Looks good. Stephen Terry is watching. That's our Jamaican buddy. The couple we met in Jamaica.
Colorado. Yeah, they live in Denver, right?
Yes.
Okay. So I got just working. A little citrus. Got some crunch in there. And what I always do with this, before I finish it up, I get a little fork and I taste to see where I'm at.
Now that's going to be for the shrimp slider.
That's
made
right.
A little slight, a light shrimp salad.
Let's see what we got. I like that. It's going to go down good. Oh, yeah, baby.
Petey Otis said, when I was a kid, my mom was sharpening her knives on a big gray rock. Old school.
Yep,
yes, sir.
Same. that never failed.
Babe, didn't you say you and your dad would sharpen knives and shine shoes?
I remember shining shoes on Saturday afternoon, sometimes Sunday morning.
Mm-hmm.
Sharpening knives on Saturday.
On Saturday.
Yeah. We sit out on the back porch. And he would get out the file, and my dad would show me how to sharpen knives. And he would pull them all out. And those are the things that you treasure.
Yes.
Growing up as a young man. All right. Slide is working. So what I'm getting ready to do, I'm going to finish these in the oven.
Okay. All right.
I'm going to see what the texture of them feel like. We're going to cook them by like a medium well. I can do medium well. I mean, medium real easy.
I need medium well, please and thank you.
That's why we're going
to
do that, okay?
All right.
So.
Peter Mayel, good evening, guys. First time watching from Cape Coral, Florida. Happy holidays. Thank you for tuning in.
So what I'm going to do next is
toast your buns.
Toast my buns. That sounds funny, don't it?
Toasted buns. It's cooking with Kip after dark.
So I made the brioche buns earlier.
Yes, Justin Herring, she's doing well. She'll be on tomorrow night. Y'all get ready to hit that join button.
So what I'm going to do, the white sesame, we're going to put shrimp. The black sesame seeds, we're going to put the venison on.
Okay.
So if I was having guests over, they could identify it in more ways than one, huh?
There you go.
Or if I was having guests over and they said, well, if I had turkey sliders, that's a good way for me to distinguish the difference, huh?
If you're just joining, he made these brioche rolls from scratch earlier today.
We're gonna cut these. Boom. Texture looks great.
It sure does.
Yeah, I'm liking where this is going. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna butter my buns. Butter my buns.
Say it again, babe.
I'm gonna butter my buns.
Thea Copeland says they add a cut up boiled egg in their shrimp salad. Ah, they eat it with Ritz crackers.
I like that. I'm going to try that.
Mm-hmm. Patricia Skipworth, hello. From York, Pennsylvania. Are you going to put cheese on it, Sharon Brown?
I'm not going to put cheese on these. I'm going to put something else. I'm going to tell you what I'm going to do in just a minute. I worked on another little item today. And we're going to just make... What I just got on my finger? Okay. Got that.
So he's cutting them up so he can toast them real good.
Yes.
Something Kip started doing back when he and I was just dating.
Okay.
What makes the difference in any sandwich or burger is the little extra love. If you take that 2 minutes to put a little butter
toast that bun.
And toast that bun, it makes all the difference in any burger or sandwich.
We're going to get both of them hot so we can come out.
Okay.
So we're going to toast the bun.
Is that mayo?
No, that's butter.
Okay.
Remember earlier I said, God damn, I'm mixing the two up?
Yes, because you just tricked me. I thought it was mayo.
Butter.
Okay.
That's a little butter here. So we're going to get them all toasted up.
Lolita said, okay, you can ship those buns to me. Thank you, Sharon Ivy Lewis.
I'm just cutting the bun. So usually when I'm toasting, searing something, you know, I can use I like using a cast iron skillet, but a stainless steel one, not stainless steel, but a good aluminum one will work as well.
And he's just buttering the buns if you're just on. Butter. That's right, Lolita. Butter. Ain't no butter. No, he said butter. Carrot butter on the homemade buns. That's Judy Camp Baker.
All right. So we're going to get that on it. And we're going to get a good little toast. It's going to get a little crunchy on it. And at the same time, give it some flavor. And I'm going to put it on all of them. Because I think, like you said, baby, that little bit of toasting of the bun goes a long way.
Delicia said buns look good. Joe Carter is watching. Thank you for joining, brother.
All right. I miss cutting bun, baby. I miss one. I try to practice safe techniques when I'm in the kitchen. So that's why I laid that bun down instead of cutting my hand.
Mm-hmm. Like I would have did.
I have to say I do it a lot if I'm doing it for myself.
Okay. So you're buttering both sides. Sharon Brown said, butter, baby, have to have the butter. Yes, ma'am.
All right, got the buns buttered. We're going to see what we can do here. See if you got it hot enough. I'll turn that one down.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I got it. That's what I wanted. A little smoke going action. I didn't get that one hot enough yet in the back. Okay. You got something happening. That's going to get hot real quick. All right, so it won't be long.
Won't be long.
What I'm going to do is I'm going to use a little bit of bib lettuce. Let's slide this over. Slide these buns over.
These okay?
How they doing? How they looking? I'm going to mash them down a little bit.
Joanne Meir says, do you have a recipe for your homemade brioche buns?
I do. It's getting toasty. It's getting toasty. Yeah, that's what I want. Mash those down. Actually, it's up. I'm going to, if you're ready to write, I'll give it to you. But if not, I'm going to have to, me and my administrator, which is one of my little cousins, I should call it little. He's a grown man now.
Mm-hmm.
He's working on getting all the recipes on the website for me. But the brioche buns are actually are not that hard. It's actually 4.5 cups of flour, 2.5 teaspoons of, I don't want that smoke in my face there, 2.5 teaspoons of yeast, 2 eggs, what else did I use? 3 tablespoons of sugar, 2 teaspoons of salt. Mix that up. You know, there's a process of mixing that up, but that's the base of the recipe. Then let it rise.
Deflate?
Deflate, and then push it down, and then mold the buns, and then let it rise again, probably about an hour, both time on the rising. And I cook them at 375 for about 20 minutes.
Nice.
So, that's a very simple recipe. I think bacon, really, if you think about it, it's not that complicated, but it's the science of it is crucial. Mm-hmm. So, measurements have to be pretty accurate, especially the measurements control the texture of baking bread as well as the rising of it. The longer it rises and the more it inflates as far as that rising, that proofing process determines the texture of the bread itself.
Okay.
So I didn't want to get too far off and burn up some buns. So.
Hello, Shirley Turner. She didn't get a notification.
Shirley.
That happens sometimes. Pool Toria, looking good, you guys. Thank you for joining.
Okay, I got some more buns going down. So we got one, two.
Is this Morel? Morel McLean said, do you have a bread machine or do you mix it by hand?
I mix it in my KitchenAid mixer, and then I knead it by hand. I do some of the kneading on the mixer.
Hello, George Cotman. Just Tavia Fuller is watching. Thank you for joining. Justin Heron said, nice little zizzle.
Yeah,
thank you, brother.
All right, so I'm going to get all the buns toasted.
Barbara Rivers, good evening, Kip. How are you doing this blessed evening?
Good.
Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. God bless you. Thank you, Miss Rivers.
Yeah, if I get them all toasted, we can turn this off, can't we?
Yes, baby. That heat is on.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
All right, how's the venison doing in the oven?
It should be fine.
If you're just joining, we're making holiday sliders, Chef Kip style. We're using venison meat. And we're also, it's like a surf and turf.
And if you're wondering how I'm picking up these buns, I'm not touching the
heated
the
surface,
I'm
right?
I'm touching the edge of the bun. Okay.
Thea Copeland says, sorry, Kip, one more time before you close. Could not get out of bed fast enough. Joanne Mears says, perfect. Thank you.
All right, I think I got all the buns toasted. Turn that off. One, two.
Martha Harvey Lewis said her husband said for you to tell her, don't try this at home.
That's funny.
Just watch. Yes, that's funny.
Okay. All the buns are toasted, folks.
All right.
Take that off the eye, hot eye.
Ain't nothing like a good toasted bun.
Write that down and get rid of that.
We're getting ready to plate, guys.
Got some meat over there.
At least the shrimp salad sliders we're getting ready to plate if you're just joining.
I'm going to do one more little trick here.
What's that, babe?
I'm going to put just a little bit of tomato.
Tomato? Tomato, tomato, potato, patata. Right here.
Okay. So you know what? I'm going to play them on the... It'll be a good thing to play them on.
Yeah, it will be. Michelle Mitchell, hi, Mr. Kip and Mrs. Kip, tuning in from Atlanta. Thank you for joining.
I'm going to put just a little bit of tomato. No, I'm not. What am I thinking? I already got tomato.
Yeah.
So somebody asked about the cheese. I made something called tomato jam. I took tomatoes, a little brown sugar.
Let's get into it. I'm going to get into it.
Brown sugar, some red pepper flakes. What else did I put in there? Some crushed cloves, a little cinnamon. So it gives it a
holiday,
sweet and sour, kind of a mix. So you get a little, both worlds in there, but a little holiday flavor as well.
So you call it a jam. Would it be a relish?
No,
it's a jam. Tomato jam.
Yeah, it's picking up. Maybe I'm gonna to get these,
Irene Smith says, yummy, I love watching you both. Your dishes look so good. Your personalities are awesome.
All right. Okay.
Thank
feel
you.
Feel pretty good about that.
Chicago watching, Howard McNeil. Hey, brother. How are you? Thank
right.
you, Justin Heron.
Okay. So for the for the beef sliders. Oh, not the beef sliders. What am I talking about?
That's not beef. Okay. Lolita said tomato jam looks delicious. Looks good, too.
Well, the venison sliders, I should say. Two, three, and then I put three on. So we have six on here all day.
Okay.
Okay.
So those are the sliders out of the oven, guys.
Yes. From here on.
And using venison, you really don't have to worry about draining oil.
No, it's not a lot in there.
It's not a lot in there.
Oh, yeah.
Going from the pan to the bun.
And that's part of that, you know, that searing process.
Mm-hmm.
That helped it too, sweetheart.
Okay.
Searing it like I did with the high heat and not pressing down on it. Because when you start pressing down on it, you're running all your
juices
out.
All your help out.
All your help out. Yeah. So we're going to take and put, I need another spoon.
Hey, Renee.
A little bit of this jam that I made. A little wonderful tomato jam. And we're going to top it. Yeah.
So with the tomato jam, you don't need no ketchup.
No, it's all that in there.
All of that is in there.
Let me tell you what else, what will be good with this.
What, baby?
And I'm going to put it on there because I think I have some in the fridge.
What's that?
We say we're going to do cheese, but I'm going to tell you what will be good with this.
What?
This is really taking it out there, man. The jam with a little bit of goat cheese will be like slamming. I'm telling you, folks.
Y'all get into it.
I think I still have some. I hope I do. I think I don't.
Don't worry about it, babe.
Did I use it the other day? Hold
Don't
on.
Worry about it. Stay focused.
So I didn't want the goat cheese, though, thank y'all.
No, the goat cheese would have been great.
You know what I am going to put on it?
What's that?
I made this little sauce the other day for an event that I had.
Mm-hmm. You going to put that on there?
Yeah.
Okay. Charlotte Turner says, look delicious. Sharon Brown, since you did say cheese.
I'm going to put a little bit of this. It has a little chipotle sauce that I made. On Wednesday, I think it was Tuesday or Wednesday.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so I still have some left over in a little container. And boom.
Justin said he thought that was the Bloody Mary the whole time.
Oh,
yeah. In the jar. Billy Jones says, awesome. Man, that looks good.
Little
mouth is watering.
Nose. Put a little pick in it. Yeah.
Babe, my mouth watering. And that's for real, for real.
Get these on there, and then we're going to do the shrimp. Do some shrimp right quick.
Okay.
We're going to put some lettuce on these. A little bit of bib lettuce. Put it on the bottom. Two.
I'm saying this right, I think. Morel McLean says, I don't do venison, but I would definitely try it.
Okay. That's what it's all about. New adventures, trying some new things. I'm going to put that on there, kind of fold it back so it get a little fan to it. Put a little shrimp on it.
Yes, Kendra, presentation is everything.
So, it's a little surf and turf, I call it. You know, we're going to overload those sliders too, aren't we?
Sharon Brown said she was drinking a Bloody Mary. I know that's right, sis. Ain't nothing like a good Bloody Mary. Hello, Danielle Jenkins. You're never late. Patricia skipped work.
No such thing in our world as being late.
No, it's all in the sauce.
That's right. It's Friday night.
That's right.
Okay, we're going to put those on. Do a cool little pick in there. These are, you can find these at like little craft stores, these little picks that I'm using, if you're wondering.
If you're just joining, Kip made homemade brioche buns today, and these are venison sliders.
And the other ones are the shrimp slider.
Or shrimp salad slider on this side. Bang!
Look, that shrimp is falling off.
It fell. There you go.
I found a home for it.
You found a home for it?
Mm-hmm.
Debbie Waltman Welch. Yes, indeed. That's what I'm talking about.
You know what we got to do?
The shrimp.
Oh, we got to garnish it with another shrimp.
A plus.
This was Ty's idea.
Yeah, I said, babe, you should put a shrimp as a garnish.
She said garnish it with, top it off with a whole shrimp.
With a whole shrimp. That one had a little skin on it, but I could sure work my way around it.
You're right, it is something on there.
Yes.
Okay.
Yvonne Hicks
I'm
going to
come over a little bit for
we
you.
We need you on the Food Network. I agree. Miss Ty, what is your website so I can order some spices and get some recipes? www.cookingwithchefkip.com.
Cooking with Kip B.
Okay, I'm sorry. Cookingwithkipb.com.
It's changed a few times.
Yes, it has. You look amazing as always, do you, Mr. Kip? Thank you, Sharon Brown. Cookingwithkipb.com. Martha says she's ready to try this.
All right. I'm getting ready to try it, Martha.
Debbie Waltman says,
music, sweetie.
I don't know what happened.
I gotta have music to try this bun. Hold on.
Hold on.
Keep talking to me.
I'm gonna get into this view. Debbie said, that's what I'm talking about, Kip. You go, Kip. Licking my lips. Looks delicious. And right. It didn't take long, guys.
No, it didn't. That was,
Well, the buns were pre-cooked, and you had pre-cooked the shrimp as well.
That's right.
But these are our venison sliders, as well as the shrimp salad sliders.
I'm coming back.
Sis, if you still on, should these be on the menu?
that's too much.
Your brother said, no, that's too much. Thank you, Lasagna Williams. Thank you for joining. Rosemary Johnson Powers is watching. I love your meme, Renee. You cooking on this Friday night? That's the drink in case you missed it.
All right. I'm back.
You back? You about to try one? You need a paper towel, babe. Lolita said she's about to jump through the screen.
Let's see. Let's try the venison first. It's a perfect compliment. You like these, baby. They almost well.
All right. I can't wait to try it.
But incredibly juicy.
But Tanya said, looking for these next year at our Bacon Clan family reunion.
I'm giving my baby a bite.
Oh my gosh, they are good.
Oh,
look. I can't talk now, bro.
No, I'll be honest with you. First time I've ever done the venison slider, I like it.
We did venison when we did the hamburgers this summer, didn't we?
No, we did the buffalo.
Buffalo, okay. Gary Craig said it looks so good. Thank y'all for joining. Now he's going to try the shrimp salad one. They're not really small bites.
That's very good.
Very good. All right.
I wish you guys were over hanging out with us.
Yes.
So, pardon me. Holiday sliders. Didn't take long. My biggest... No, you want to try one? You don't want to be on the camera, do you? You can't get one now.
Lola just came down. That baby know when to come. Lolita said we had venison when they were here, remember?
Yeah.
When we were there, rather, in San Antonio. Mm-hmm.
Well, this is good. Didn't take long. Good sharing food. Good thing, you know, good plating for it. And the good thing about serving it like this, if it was a group of people, once we ate them, they were gone. We wouldn't even have to use plates.
Nope, grab and go.
Pre-COVID. But we've enjoyed it. So it's been a lot of fun doing this. Good party food. We got 2 more weeks of this. And then we're going to move on to some other stuff. Tomorrow, Mom's hanging out with us at 5. You don't have anything to do. Hang out with us live at 5 because Mom's going to be over hooking up with her baby boy. And all that you get and all the fun that we're having, hey, it's all about love, peace, and taking care of each other. Coming to the end of the year, let's make somebody happy. Let's put a smile on someone's face. If you can, if you're fortunate enough to help someone else, do that, because that's the reason for this season. Love you guys. Cooking with Kip, After Dark. Me and Ty hanging out with you tonight. So hopefully we see you tomorrow at 5. Have a good night. Ginger beer, a little dark rum, and some surf and turf sliders. Y'all have a good night. It's fun.
She said, when you move your hand like that, you know it's good. That was our featured drink for the night with the ginger
beer. I'm having another bite.
Have another bite, baby. Good night. Thank you all for joining. Happy holidays. Get it, babe. Bye.